is in Princess Street, and I was here with the girls yesterday, and I thought I was dropping my friend to an appointment today, and I had some time, and I thought, I'm in front of your view of the fountain there, and I want you to see it. And I thought, what a lovely image, the fountain and the castle behind. And I had this, I had my materials in the boot of the car still since yesterday, so I bought this board with me, and I'm going to do a drawing, just a short one because I'm picking her up shortly. But I'm going to do a drawing here, and I'm going to face the camera towards the drawing now, but just feast your eyes on that lovely view. Isn't it gorgeous? Right bang in the centre of Edinburgh Castle, and this is the Princess Street Gardens. Okay, so welcome, welcome. I've got my oil pastels and ink, and I'll probably just use a stick, that as a stick to draw with. We'll see. I've got my good dress on now, so I don't want to be spilling anything. Okay, but I'll face you down, and hopefully you'll be able to see what I'm up to as I'm working. And it'll be a swift thing, we'll see. I'm not sure what's going to happen on the board. Should get myself started first, maybe. As you know, it's always a bit of a juggling act, this whole thing of impromptu drawing. I suppose I could put my cardigan underneath the board and keep it propped up a little bit that way. Okay, that's not a bad view that you've got there, I don't think. My shadow's coming across it, but if I go on this side, there we are. Okay. Right, take off my shoes. You should really take my phone out now so that I'm not late. No film. Just take my phone out and set an alarm maybe. Because you know what I'm like. I'm just going to take my phone out and set an alarm because there's a small chance I may get lost in the drawing. So bear with me for 1 second while I set a timer. Yeah, so Quentin lets you do it, eh? Famous last words. I set it for 22 minutes, my lucky number. Okay. Here we go. I'm gonna start. Yeah. I think I'll start with paper towel. Good for me. No, actually I started before I left the car because I just found some blue paint left on the palette, and so I put that onto this, the area where I thought might represent the sky. Just the top there. So it's kind of worked out really, because I like the thing, the lengthy thing. So the fountain will be here, and then there'll be, you know, the general shape of the castle looking at the ground right out there. Castle on the skyline. Okay. I might even bring in some of the, there's a gorgeous blue-green. Or maybe, I'm just wondering about bringing colour in or not. If I had a colour that would represent the fountain really well, I would use it. But what I've got is this mixed with this, I think. And then some white would probably do it. So it's a bit of a faff, like three things. But maybe with that there, I could just rub it around and make a greenish. Yeah, that's not bad. I'll do that again. So, I think it was this blue. Yeah, so there's this figure that's rising up there. So it's this blue. And there's the two sections of the fountain, and then the water down here. There's this blue, and then this green. And I can use the ink to subdue it a little bit as well if it's too bright. And then the white. I mean, when I half close my eyes, really, quite a lot of it is in shadow too. So let's see now if I can spread this out again. Kind of a shape that'll represent the fountain. I hope you can see it like that. Got a bit of a gel going on in the background. Okay, happy enough with that shape. That's good. And I think I could use my lunchbox as a little holder for the ink so that I can draw with it. With the paper towel as well, so I'm getting it all over my fingers and everything like that. It'll be a bit of a task not to get it on my lovely dress. Well, it's lovely to me. This is my happy dress. If I'm not feeling happy already, it makes me happy. If I am feeling happy already, it's that. Okay. I'm going to do something now to create the dark backdrop for the fountain. It's really quite dark behind there. So I'm putting the green in because it's green there. So the oil pastel that I'm mixing with the ink, the water down my eyes half closed. Checking out this incredible fountain in Prince Street Gardens in Edinburgh. And that's still kind of a lovely colour as well, the rock. Lilac. There's a video of me painting the chapel, the castle from my friend George's studio, which is overlooking the gardens here. He's an incredible studio job. George McLean, he's an incredible man actually. He and his wife and have had an adventurous life. Anyway, he lives probably overlooking me right now. That's where he lives. And there's a couple of paintings that I did from his studio of the castle. At least one anyway. So I remember painting this lilac coloured rock. It was ultramarine blue I think I ended up using for that rock. Surprising, like you wouldn't expect it to be that shade, but I'm not getting it today now really because I don't have a huge selection, but it's something like that. Something like that shade. And of course it is in shadow behind the fountain, it's darker. So I'm subduing it a little bit. It's only dark because the fountain is so light. And that up there is the castle of course, which I'm not doing a huge amount of justice to, but I'm prioritizing. I guess the foreground too could be established a bit more clearly so that you know there's something going on there. Could it be the grass? Lots of tourists, kind of heartening to see. That would be the line of grass, and then beyond that towards us is the, again, that kind of lilac-y colour for the tarmac. I think works almost, not quite, but it's okay. A bit of that mixed maybe with a touch of yellow ochre just to subdue it a little bit. Maybe this darker blue. So it's nice and warm too, so the pastels are really soft. And then a bit of white in the mix. And it's almost like oil paint. Then when I use the paper towel I can spread it out. Now I want to use a clean bit of paper towel for this because actually the tarmac in front of the fountain is really quite light coloured. So I don't want the Indian ink getting into that and making it all dark. It's kind of lilac-y too, so maybe a touch of red in there would help. Yeah. It's setting it apart anyway, to be honest. And I like the red in the foreground, so I'm going to stick a touch of red into that there as well. And then there's that gorgeous yellow-green grass right at the top where the castle is. There's a couple of splashes of bright green, spring-green grass above the wall there. I think I might use my non-dominant hand to draw. Of course, I took out the black oil pastel yesterday, so I don't have that today now, but Maybe I'll just draw with the in the next step. I don't want the ink to spill. Let's see if I can lay it down there. Good. So I can stick it again. Okay, so I suppose it's the first thing to pick up first. We should figure out the top there. And then there's, I suppose, are there the three graces maybe down there underneath? That layer, not sure. Gorgeous water flowing and everything. I don't know. I left that for just to carry on with the figures for now. I have an idea of the Indian ink and a stick being quite a good thing to work with to draw that fountain. Combined with the oil pastel, I like that combination usually. And there's a seagull sitting at the very top of the fountain there. I wish I could show you, I will show you. It's a window. Let's take a look at it. And they get a good shape, you know, because it's windy again. Okay. And there is this amazing gold top to the fountain too. I think I will do that next, yes. It's yellow ochre, but it's yellow ochre with white in it, so I'll use the white to lighten it and give it a feeling of the gold underneath it, and the yellow ochre on its own, because that is a bit in shadow and not so bright. And possibly the head's better with the three graces or whatever they are. Could have a touch of the yellow ochre too, with the white. Yeah, because they really are gold. Twisting it around to create a kind of an aliveness in the mark making too. Yeah. I'm sure I could describe the edge of the castle maybe a little bit too with this white pastel now. Find the shape of it there. And it slopes up the way. It's kind of interesting with this colour, oil pastel is very light. Colour of the sky, thankfully. I need a little bit more, ink to describe how it's higher up there on this side. And to get the distance and narrowing it in, to get the feeling of height, it's towering. Towering above the fountain here. So this gable end wall will be closer to that grassy bit. And then you're going to miss some of the turrets that are over to the right, but that's okay, because I was wanting an elongated feel. And down here now I'm going to do some... Is there any brown? I don't have the dark brown. There's a nice dark brown colour. I could make it again, you know, but it's a bit of a faff, isn't it, mixing three or four oil pastels together. I wouldn't want to do it too often. I'm feeling like it's worthwhile here again to do that. There's a kind of a purpley blue that I want to. Anyway, so there we have something brownish, maybe, with the red, yellow ochre and the green oil pastel. I've made something that makes me feel a little bit better about the colour. I could bring some orange actually in there too. And then to cancel out the orange, a little bit of the blue. The yellow wanted to come along for the red there. Okay, so there we have it. I suppose I could use that yellow. These things happen for a reason sometimes, don't they? Could bring the yellow into that gold mix as well. And there's a ball that looks quite yellowish, a goldy ball. The seagull is still at the top, but I think I'm going to let him off. I don't think I'm going to paint him. So these figures down here are the same colour really as the figures up here, so I could triple that in. Make something a little bit darker and bring some tone as well as line into the fountain. If I only had a nice brown, that would have been a good job there now, because there's quite a few brown figures on the fountain. Well, I just
I'll try and make it. Lovely bronze quality that these figures have. What colour would I mix with that now? So I'm forgetting that they're figures at all really, I'm just looking for the darks and light shapes. Dark and light shapes.
Here we go now with the ink.
I'm trying to explain it again. There's a little bit more colour underneath this thing, which I think will be helpful. A bit more tone. So to give more substance. Sit back there and remember it's there. I'm sitting the ink against the drawing board, so shout at me if it starts to fall. So you could use a twig just the same. This is just a spray bottle that I'm using, the tube out of the spray bottle to draw it. Little creatures bent over down there. So this big lump of pink there. The thing about ink is you have very little control really, it's dipped into ink and it gives it a feeling of freshness than anything. So there's a tree here as well, and I could later when the ink is dry maybe splash on a bit of greenery for that tree. For now it's enough just to let us know that there's something in the foreground there. So that tree is made of bright spring green tree. And then the bottom of the fountain on that side, and the bottom of the fountain on this side. There's a little bit more going on in the foreground, I think, that I could try and establish with some oil pastel greens and things. I don't know. Oh, I left all of that over there, I'm not sure. Yeah, it's not going anymore now. I think I will bring some greenery into that. The thing is, it's a spring yellow green, not so much the blue green. Just the edges of it. It's quite dark against the sky up there. Just the tips that have light on them. Oh, bad place to be in a summer's day. Myself and my friend are going to get a crepe after. There's a lovely spot that does takeaway crepes. They make them there. It's gorgeous. Looking forward to that. Pull out this fountain a little bit from the background, bring some lights into that turquoisey fountain colour. And Kili brings some light into the sky. To the castle on the hill. Way up on the hill. Architecture up there, little steps along the roof. Different things there. Yeah, you can see it's by no means an architectural drawing, but there's a joy in sitting here and capturing something of the feel of the place. And I'm not back that greenery because it's a significant thing, that green. And I wanted to really read us the position it's in relation to the chapel and the size that it is. And I want to put some white and some yellow into that green to create the freshness of the grass that's there. It's pretty red and yellow. It's alright. I'm sure there's some more of that yellow green down here at the bottom of the fountain. Yellow one first. I want to really let the fountain stand out. In the background. It's kind of handy mixing the colours to make it more similar to the colour of the fountain. I think we could do with a bit more shadow under there. Handy having that drop of Indian ink. Let's see if my phone is on silent. Oh, looks like I've got 44 seconds left. 40 seconds now. Okay. I take that as a good omen because 44 is another lucky number of me.
there's my timer. And I have about another 5 minutes, so I'll carry on a little bit longer to explain the walls in front of the castle there. And then I'll head back. Then I'll tidy up and I'll head back. Because there's a bit of tidying up to be done after this kind of carry on. Maybe subdue things. I mean, the castle could do with a bit of warmth, and I couldn't have just a touch of yellow over here and there. And I can rub it on in with the kitchen paper maybe. It feels like a bit of yellow ochre in the vegetation dropping down the hillside there too. And those lions with the water pouring from their mouths are yellow ochre-ish. Well, they're gold really, but the best I've got for gold is yellow ochre with some white. Or maybe a flash of some clean yellow. More things spouting water up on this level too. This gold thing at the very top is appealing. I bet the seagull has abandoned it. It was nice with the seagull on it too, in fact. But just not red. It would have been another thing to draw, so. And it might have looked prior to the architecture, which I didn't really want, just with the nature of the drawing. At other times, a seagull is just the thing to embellish your painting. And there's lots of seagulls around there. So at the front here, there's like a railing. Might be a nice division. I don't know if you've been frustrating me not able to see this or if it's worked out okay for you to see, I'm not sure. If you work like that, you can see the full thing maybe. There we are. Just a little bit of blue sky, we can pretend. I should really take the paper off that before trying to. It's just the paper that's smudging it around with this. It's actually very good white oil pastel. You see how much the coverage works. Maybe the swirling around gives a feeling of the menacing Edinburgh sky. It's really bright in between those leaves. Those leaves are quite dark with the backlit sky. This here is going to be dark, dark, dark. Misty, dark in there. Just a little scattering. Let's go. A little scattering of some of the leaves. Represented here by lemon yellow. And in the water. Really needs rock and roll now. The water is a bit murky looking. That'll do it. Okay. So it's the sun first, maybe first I thought it would, because it'd be just like you to see what it's to see it spilling. Okay, so there we have the fountain and the castle. And there we have my fountain and castle. Show you a little bit closer. It's actually recognisable anyway, I think. So, from Princess Street Gardens, it's been a real pleasure, and I'll see you maybe tomorrow. Okay. Okay, have a go at drawing something on the skyline, looking up. It's really good fun. Okay. All right. Bye.